हेलो फ्रेंड्स, एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट। कंसीडर अ पार्टिकल रिवॉल्विंग अलोंग द सर्कमफेरेंस ऑफ ए सर्कल। दिस इज द वाई एक्सिस, y dash, y y dash. Let us consider particle A which is revolving along the circumference of the circle. This is the circumference of the circle. Let O is the center of the circle. Now the particle is revolving along the circumference of the circle in anti-clockwise direction. So this direction is anti-clockwise direction. Circle of radius r. Now a vector is drawn from the center of the circle to the position of a particle A. This vector is called as radius vector. That is, AO is radius vector. Sometime it is called as position vector or position vector. Now the direction of the position vector or radius vector changes along the circumference of the circle as the particle moves from position A to the position B. Suppose particle moves from position A to the position B in time t. So the radius vector or position vector will change from OA to OB. Now it's subscribed an angle theta over here. This distance is called as arc length. Arc length S. This is the theta. Now angular displacement is defined as the angle subscribed by radius vector in a given time at the center of the circle. Let A is initial position of particle t equals to 0. B is final position of the particle at time t. Theta is angular displacement in time t. Displacement r is the radius of circle. S is the length of arc AB. Therefore, theta angular displacement is defined as arc length. This is the arc length divided by radius. Arc length by radius. Therefore, angular displacement theta equals to S by R. Its unit is radian. From this equation, we can use S equals to R theta. S is the arc length, R is the radius, and theta is the angular displacement of a particle which is moving along the circumference of the circle. Now, we will discuss angular velocity. Angular velocity. We know that angular displacement is the angle described by the radius vector in a given time at the center of the circle. It happens because particle is changing its position along the circumference from point A to B. That's why this radius vector or position vector is describing an angle. That angle is called as angular displacement. Angular velocity, the rate of change of angular displacement or position is called angular velocity. Velocity. The angular velocity is denoted by a letter omega. So, angular infinite or instantaneous velocity omega equals to limit delta t tends to 0 del theta by del t, that is equals to d theta by dt. This is the rate of change of angular displacement. So, the finite angular velocity omega equals to theta by t. Theta is angular displacement at time t. So, unit of angular displacement is radian per second. Now, we will discuss angular acceleration. Hello friends, now we will see definition of angular acceleration. It is denoted by letter alpha. It's called as angular acceleration. Its unit is rad per second square, radian per second square. The rate of change of angular velocity, rate of is called angular acceleration. Alpha equals to rate of change of angular velocity. Omega is the angular velocity. We know that rate of change of angular displacement is called as angular velocity. Therefore, alpha equals to d square theta by dt square. As we have discussed here, unit is radian per second square. Dimensions are m0, l0, t minus square. Now we will see relation between angular velocity and linear velocity. As we know that angular velocity is denoted by omega, linear velocity is v, linear velocity meter per second, angular velocity radian per second. We know that arc length s equals to r into theta. S is the arc length, r is the radius of a circle, and theta is angular displacement. This arc length is for finite displacement. Suppose the displacement is infinite, then we can write del S equals to r into delta theta for infinite displacement, dividing both side by delta t. Here we are getting ds by delta t, r del theta by del t. Now this term, see here, del s by del t is the linear displacement. We can replace that term by velocity v, where velocity is the linear velocity equals to r is the radius of the circle, del theta by del t. This term indicate rate of change of displacement. Therefore, we can replace this term by angular velocity. So, linear velocity equals to radius time angular velocity. So, this is the relation between angular velocity and linear velocity, where v is linear speed of a particle. Now we will discuss the three equations of motions. So if the angular acceleration alpha is constant, then we have theta equals to omega 0 t plus half time alpha t square, equation number 1, then omega equals to omega 0 plus alpha t, equation number 2, omega square equals to omega 0 square plus 2 alpha theta, equation number 3. So these are the three equations when angular displacement is done by the particle. First equation is angular displacement theta equals to omega 0 into t plus half time alpha t square. We know that alpha is the angular acceleration which is constant. Omega 0 is the angular velocity when time t equals to 0, and omega is the angular velocity of the particle at time t, and theta is the angular position at time t. Thank you.